is Timothytrespas. He found himself targeted with morgellons and other unknown diseases, like stalking.
Oh yeah, he told me.
Directed energy. The whole nine yards. I just wanted to speak briefly about panic attacks, my panic attacks. You see, I have a high frequency, loud noise that I hear inside my head. Constantly, 24/7, and when it gets louder, I begin to feel panic attacks, fear, all the things that come from PTSD and panic attacks, chest pains, the dizziness, the loss of vision, the confusion, the shutting down of the higher thought and reason, lower tolerance for frustration, emotional lability, and shaking, coldness, numbness in hands and feet, all of these things. Excuse me. And whenever I go outside around people now, I feel that way. Whenever I, basically every time I wake up, it begins. It goes through my sleep. It happens throughout the day, over and over. And reading about Lyme disease and some other neuropathic conditions, certain diseases, viruses, or infections can reduce the magnesium in your body, and somehow the magnesium in the nerve cells is important for channel, neuron channel gating, something to do with turning the neurons off or after they've been fired, and so also something to do with the myelin, the sheath, the nerve sheathing, something that covers the nerves, and when this gets damaged, a couple of things happen. The neurons keep firing, over fire, I believe, unless I'm confusing things, and the nerves become more exposed and more able to pick up things, so that your response becomes, you hear a sound and you go into fight or flight, you feel like you're being attacked, you hear a bang and you jump because you feel like you're attacked. Your body goes into fight or flight, and I spend a lot of my time in this state, fear and confusion and difficulty prioritizing, difficulty deciding what to do, intention tremor, sort of standing there going, unsure of what action to take, what's the correct choice, difficulty prioritizing, thinking clearly. And it's almost as if the level of the high frequency changes, and my response to stimulus stressors changes. The panic attacks seem to increase, and it's very difficult for me to function in the normal world with this debilitating condition. They've given me some medication to take, alprazolam or whatever, which is a highly, it's not a great medicine for long-term use because it's very addictive and your body becomes used to it, and then when you don't have it, you get worse, you have a rebound effect. But I made the choice because I'm so sick and living for so many years, 2-3 years with intense fear and panic attacks, it's just too much. And so I decided to take this medication. But the other problem with it is that it puts you to sleep, which is great when you have insomnia, but not so good when you need to do things like pack everything your own, clean the bugs off it, and move it to a new place. And I have so much stress and fear and anxiety, and it's very hard for me to think positively about anything at this point. Some of that is because of the programming that goes on, the nightly drumming of the negative thoughts, behaviors, and impulses, and I wake up believing in my own self, but then I realize after comparison and deep insight that it doesn't really seem like me. It's more a part of me or something pretending to be me or wanting to be me. I know that sounds like mental illness, but it's the only way I can explain this feeling. Sometimes I awaken with thought patterns that, reaffirming negative self belief structures, and I have to actually look around the world and compare and say, right, well, you know, maybe I'm not such great a guy, but look at all these other people. There's so many people that are so much more horrible than I am. And so that I'm not, by comparison, whatever you have to do to make yourself feel like you're not garbage, which seems to be one of the things that, for whatever reason, I am sentenced to, this break you down and build you back up. But when they break you down so far that you're broken, you can't fix it. Anyway, dealing with the panic attacks is very difficult. Constant stressors and trauma and meditation practice doesn't help me very much. Prayer doesn't seem to help me very much. I used to do this thing with this Tibetan bell, and that actually helped a lot, but they took that, the watchers took that away, so... anyway. Thanks for watching.